हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज वर्षा सिंह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर चितकारा कॉलेज ऑफ हॉस्पिटैलिटी मैनेजमेंट, चितकारा यूनिवर्सिटी, पंजाब. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट कलर हार्मनी. एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कलर्स एंड व्हाट आर द डायमेंशंस ऑफ कलर इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो, एंड टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द कलर हार्मनी. कलर हार्मनी मीन्स प्लीजिंग, इफेक्टिव, कॉन्ग्रुएंट एंड बैलेंस्ड कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू और मोर कलर्स और शेड्स. It does not imply a random mixing of colors, but a purposeful selection of a number of colors to get a desired effect is called the color harmony. And it is usually achieved by combining related or contrasting colors. So as color harmony is divided into two classes, that is related color schemes and contrasting color schemes. Related color scheme is further divided into two subclasses, that is monochromatic color scheme and analogous color scheme. Similarly, contrasting color scheme is further divided into five subclasses, that is complementary color scheme, double complementary color scheme, split complementary color scheme, triad color scheme, and neutral color scheme. Now, if we are talking about the color schemes, so a color scheme is a combination of colors which we are generally used for the decorating purpose, whether doing up interior or for designing a dress or any other purpose, like for the interior, for the aesthetic appealing of a particular place in a hotel or at your home also. So there are two main types of color schemes, as I have already told you, related and contrasting. So make sure when using color schemes to select colors that you like, only prefer those colors which you like. So there are some basic color schemes which have worked well for many years. So let's see one by one each color scheme. First is monochromatic color scheme. This is also called a one hue or one mode harmony. Actually, it evolves only one or the single colors which is present in a color means, as you already knows that key color scheme, or we can say that the color means having 12 colors in which 3 are primary colors, 3 are secondary colors, and 6 are tertiary colors. You can pick any one color from the color scheme or from the color wheel. For example, if you are taking a blue, so you can take a tint and shade of blue, like light blue, dark blue, pure hue, any shades and the tint of this particular pure hue, as you have seen in picture also. So only single color we can show in a different shades and hue, which we call it monochromatic. Common single color, right? Second is analogous color scheme. Analogous color schemes, these are based on hues that lies next to each other on the color. So this scheme can have a minimum of two colors and a maximum of three colors. So the hue should differ in their intensities and values. And analogous color schemes, although basically harmonious, they have more variety and interest than monochromatic color schemes. That's why mostly people are prefer this analogous color schemes rather than the monochromatic color scheme. Next is complementary color scheme. Complementary, these are built on any two hues which are directly opposite to each other on a color wheel. For example, red and green. The complementary color of red in a color wheel is green only. So you can take any color and the complementary color of that particular hue. That is called the complementary color scheme. Then double complementary color scheme. Similarly, as we have seen in the complementary color schemes, you can pick any two color from the color wheel and the opposite color of these particular two colors. For example, red, if you are taking red, the opposite color or the complementary color of red is green. And if you are taking yellow, then the opposite and the complementary color of yellow is violet. Clear? So these are built on any two hues, any two adjacent colors and their complements used together for a double complementary color scheme. So double complementary schemes combine the harmonious aspects of analogous color with the contrast found in complementary combinations. Next one is split complementary. Another variation of complementary theme is the split complementary, which is composed of any hue together with two hues on either side of its complement, or we can say that the opposite of the complementary color. Okay, for example, if we are taking the red colors, the opposite or the complementary color of red is green. So you cannot take the green colors, take the adjacent of this particular complement. Green, the dark green and the light green is the adjacent color of the complementary color, right? So one of three is selected on the main colors and the other two are used to accentuate it. So this makes the contrast less violent than in the simple complementary type of schemes, and obviously add the interest and the variety. Next is triad. A triadic or triangular color scheme, we can say that, is made up of any three colors which are present in a color wheel that are equidistant from each other on the color wheel. So it should be remembered that full intensity hues are seldom used in decorating interiors, and this is particularly true here. So you can take any three colors which are equidistant in the color wheel. Next is neutral. This is a type of scheme in which most of the areas of the room are in expanses of neutral colors, with small areas of a bright colors used for accented, right? So what are the neutral colors? White, black, gray and beige. These are the neutral colors. So if you are taking the interior, if you are interested in doing an interior of that particular small areas, you can use these accented neutral colors. Then again, coming towards the warm colors, as I've already told you in the previous video, warm colors are colors which are present in the warm side of the spectrum, and it includes red, yellow and orange. Cool colors which are present on the cool side of the spectrum, which includes blue, violet and green. So this is all about the color schemes. So I hope you understood, and this will work while you're doing interior for a particular area. Thank you very much.